Actually, it's a polynomial. Okay, so definition is not given in your book in so many words. Not an accurate definition is not given, but let's just do it because it is important. Okay, the book refers to class 9 text actually. Okay, so it's necessary that we cover it. So here we'll deal with polynomials only in one variable. Okay, so that variable can be x. Okay, it could be y. But the idea is that there is a single variable that we are concerned about. Okay, so there are expressions in variable, a single variable. So we would only be concerned about a single variable polynomial. It has many terms, and each of the term is of the form, let's say that it's a polynomial in variable x. So each of our term is of this form. It has many such terms. So there could be a second term as well. Okay, so just call it a1 n1. Then the second term becomes a2 xn2. And so on and so forth. So there can be many such terms. Okay, where the key point being that n is non-negative. So this n1, n2 and so on, they are non-negative integer. They can only be integers. Non-negative integers means they can only be natural numbers. Okay, and of course zeros also. So they can be any of the whole numbers, this n1, n2. Okay? So let's just write that n1, n2, etc. They are all whole numbers. So they can be 0, 1, and so on. And A can possibly only be real numbers. So they are only real numbers. Both rational as well as irrational values of A are allowed. So A's can be of the form, okay, so this is AI, any A, we are talking about any A. They can be of the form B by Q. Okay, so they can be rational numbers, as well as they can be of the form root P, where P is of course a prime number. Okay, so they can be both rational as well as irrational numbers. Okay, so they're allowed to be any real numbers. So this is the polynomial. We're talking only about polynomial in a single variable. That is what is covered in your syllabus, in a single variable. Here we have taken that variable to be x, but I might as well replace it with variable y, making no difference at all, right? So I can very well write it as this. Notice that I have used only plus signs here, because these b1, b2s, b3s, if I indeed want a negative here, then I would push this negative inside the coefficient. These are known as the coefficient of the terms. B1, B2 are the coefficients, and N1, N2 is the degree. These are known as the degree of the term. So if I want to generate a negative term here, then I would use a negative coefficient. Okay. So here the plus does not remove any generality from the definition of the polynomial. The degree of this polynomial, let's say that I write a polynomial. For example, I can write any polynomial that I want. So here let's just say that I wrote a polynomial ax square plus bx, right? So ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, the degree of this polynomial is the largest exponent in the polynomial. Okay, so the largest exponent in any of these terms, ax, bx, and c. Right? Here, it is implied that the exponent is 0. Here, the exponent is 1. The largest power of the any of these variables is the degree of that polynomial. So this polynomial is of degree 2, which we also call the quadratic polynomial. Now here, let's delve upon the three kinds of polynomial which are discussed in your chapter, which are in your syllabus, and you should definitely know about those. One is the linear polynomial. Linear polynomial means that the degree of this polynomial, the degree, the highest exponent of any of the terms is 1. For quadratic, the highest exponent of the variable in any of the terms, okay, is 2. So here the highest exponent is, of course, 2. So that is the degree. For cubic, the highest exponent is 3. Okay, and therefore the degree is 3, or it is the cubic polynomial. So these are the three kinds of polynomials you should know about. Now, one of the things that we need to understand here, which is given in your book and you should also understand, is that this x, the degree of x in a polynomial, okay, let's just go behind here in a second. And the degree of x, the n, cannot be negative, okay, and it is to be emphasized here that the x here, the n here, the degree of x, okay, can never be negative in a polynomial, which means that I can never have a polynomial like this, a divided by x, because this, let's say I'll complete it, plus bx, I can never have it, because here the exponent of x is actually minus 1. This is what it means. Okay, if I bring the denominator to the numerator, I make the power as negative. So here it was x raised to power 1, here I will write it at x raised to power minus 1 when I bring it to numerator. And here, since the exponent is negative, it is not a polynomial. A polynomial always has only the 0, the exponent of the variables can only be 0 or a positive number. Okay, so that is very important to remember, because in your exam, a question would come where you would be asked, given a polynomial, you have to understand whether it is a a valid polynomial or not, given an algebraic expression, whether it's a valid polynomial or not. Another thing to understand here is that this B and C, they can be roots of prime numbers. So root 3 is allowed as coefficients. That is okay because those are also real numbers. Okay? So those are allowed where A, B, C are real numbers. So it is very important. Another thing to understand here is that this the exponent, this coefficient of the highest term cannot be 0. Okay? So this is A is here, AX square. It is missing from this equation. So this is AX square. And this A, and this A cannot be 0. Okay? It is very important because if it, let's say that I say 0X square plus BX plus C. If I write a polynomial like this, then you'll say that, oh, this doesn't really exist. Okay, it is 0. So this will, instead of becoming a quadratic polynomial, it would become a linear polynomial. Okay, and we are talking really about quadratic polynomials. Of course, B is allowed to be 0. Okay? Only the highest power, the coefficient of the highest power is cannot be 0. I can have a very well have a polynomial such as this, AX square plus 0X plus C. And that is okay because the highest power is non-zero. Here if I have 0, that is okay. Okay. Similarly, C can also be 0. That is also fine. That is